Okay, guys, welcome to BA31. Let me turn this music off. Okay, welcome to BA31. First video, beginning of the summer. I hope you're happy to be here, as happy as I am to be here. This video, as all the rest, sponsored by Brooklyn Body Gear, the best underwear money can buy, and full disclosure, my company. Okay, so, BA31, organizational behavior. Why do we learn organizational behavior? Why do we even have to learn this subject? What's it all about? Okay, we're gonna be learning about ourselves in a work environment. In a work environment, everybody acts a certain way. We all bring our own personalities, we bring our own issues, we bring our own cultures to the work environment. Everybody working together, there's sometimes problems and issues, especially in reference to teamwork. We're gonna be learning all about this particular subject, okay? We're gonna be learning about others, how to deal with others, okay? And it also helps you understand the way the organization works and helps you be able to understand the way you work in a group environment and the way others work in a group environment. And of course, it applies everywhere. An organization is a group of people, a group of two or more people who come together for a particular reason. That's what an organization is. So give an example of organizations. Football team is an organization. Your work environment is an organization. Our class is an organization, right? Two or more people coming together for a particular reason. What's the reason? To learn BA31, to learn from Professor Didia, okay? And I have a beer club. I run a beer club. What's the idea? We come together to sample different types of beers. The point is, do I have to even like these people? No. Because the idea is not, are they my friends? No. The idea is for a particular reason. We come together to drink beer. I don't have to like them. Same thing in a work environment. Same thing in a team environment. The stuff that I gave you to do as a teamwork, you don't get to choose who's on your team. You're there. Your team project, your team weekly assignment is to understand that working in a work environment, you don't get to pick who you're working with. You're there for a particular purpose, to do the assignment, okay? I'm in my beer club. I don't like the people in my beer club. I hope they don't see this video because I don't really like them. I'm there because we drink beer. We speak about beer. We talk about the different nuances of beer, okay? So that's organizational behavior. Okay, so the OB model. For the individual, it's about job satisfaction. It's about motivation. It's about empowerment, okay? It's about empowerment. Someone who is empowered in their job feels responsible and more motivated. And if you feel empowered, if the boss gives you responsibility and you feel empowered, you're going to be more motivated to do the job. And of course, the individual has to do with ethics, your own ethics, your values, your attitude that you bring to the company. We all have different levels of integrity. We all have different levels of ethical behavior. We all have different cultures. And we're all bringing this to the work environment, okay? The OB model in a group is all about being able to work together and the diversity in a group. Is diversity good or bad? Well, I'll give you the quick answer right now. Diversity is good, and I'm going to explain to you why later. And it's not because, I'm not going to say diversity is good because, oh, it's better because we want to feel inclusion and stuff like that. No, when it comes to the work environment, it's all about making money. It's all about performing as a team for the betterment of the company. So, would it be in the company's best interest to find someone to work in the company that will not work well together just because they fit a certain diverse category? Of course not. So we're gonna talk more about diversity, but I'm gonna explain to you why I believe diversity is very good as time goes on. And the OB model from an organizational standpoint. Okay, so about customer service. Friendly, courteous, helpful. This is all about customer service, doing the right thing in the company. Okay, innovation. If the work environment and the people are happy, you're gonna innovate. Innovation makes more money for the company, okay? And it makes the company more successful and flexibility to change, okay? Easier to be more nimble if you are focusing on the organizational model for the company. Okay, quality and productivity, all about effectiveness, right? Achievement of goals, efficiency, how much input to get output. Remember, when it comes to work environment, we want to have employees work more, create more profit, more than what you're paying them, right? We don't want anyone to work to cost us money. So a happier employee is going to be a more productive employee, and it's going to be more efficient for the company, okay? Globalization. The world is a much smaller place. COVID maybe is going to change things, but the world is a much smaller place. So through globalization, we have to understand working with different cultures. As we discussed, or we will discuss a lot with Brooklyn Body Gear, my factory is in China, and there's a lot of cultural differences that I have to understand when I'm dealing with China. And of course, the work environment and organizational values. To succeed at work, work-life balance, remember, the organizational culture and the organizational environment, is it good or bad for the employee? One thing in mind, if you took my BA14 class in marketing, there was always one word that sums up the whole class. In BA14, in marketing, the one word is value, right? Relationship between cost versus benefits. The one word for this class is this. Fit. Fit. F-I-T. Fit. What does fit mean? Fit. The right person doing the right job. Okay? The right person that brings the right skills to the right job in the right company. That is fit. To get the perfect fit is a challenge. And this is why we learn organizational behavior. We're going to be learning about sociology, the study of people in relation to social environment. We're going to be learning a little bit of psychology, okay, about human behavior and how to possibly change human behavior in a work environment. Everything is going to go back to the work environment. So we're not going to talk that much about sociology except how it affects the company. We're not going to talk that much about psychology that you take a psychology class about. We are going to talk about psychology in reference to the work environment. Okay? Social psychology, people and the influence on each other. We all know about leadership and followers, leaders and followers. Imagine that in a work environment. Okay? And a little bit about anthropology, study of society. So remember, we're going to only touch on all of these as it relates to a company and how and as it relates to organizational behavior. So I hope you're ready for the ride, because it's really going to be fun. Let's start chapter one, guys. Okay, chapter one. So we're going to be introducing organizational behavior. So the way it works with the class is that always the first chapter is going to explain a little bit of everything. So remember, we already spoke about, I want you to watch these videos and read the chapter, or at least skim the chapter, watch the video, and then go back and understand everything more. Obviously, I can't do as much as we could do in a class, but this is an online class, and of course, I'm always here for you. So, it's all about people. People make the difference in a company. Good or bad, people make the difference. Bad person is going to bring down the company. Good people will bring up the company. Of course, like I said, I can speak to this because I have my own company, Brooklyn Body Gear. I have my own company, and I've worked in many companies. So through my own company, I have a lot of people that do work for me, and it's all about finding the right fit. Okay, I've had to, unfortunately, fire a few people. I've had to beg people to stay that I felt were really good, and they didn't want to stay, so they were the right fit for me, but I wasn't the right fit for them. Remember, once again, back to fit. So let's start, okay? So what is organizational behavior? We already spoke about this a little bit. Study of human behavior in organizations, okay? It's about understanding individual and group behavior, and the dynamics between people in an organization, okay? What's the importance of it? Create a smart workforce. Remember, common foundations with similar behaviors. And drive titles, networking, connecting, everything's going to be collaboration. If you went on a job interview today and said, you know something, I really like to work by myself. I'm really a very independent worker. Trust me, you will not get the job, okay? You will not get the job. Everything today is about collaboration. Everything is about teamwork. Well, we're going to see because of COVID how teamwork is going to evolve. maybe more on Zoom, maybe more on video conferencing, teleconferencing, which happened even before COVID. But we're going to see how this works. But a lot of it is about teamwork, okay? And helping, linking, supporting, seeking, and performing. It's all being by yourself, working in the corner. That is not today. That is not 2020. That is not business in 2020. It's all about teamwork and collaboration. Okay? So, the trends in human behavior, these are some of the trends that are going on now. Commitment to ethical behavior. Everybody's thinking about ethics now. Doing the right thing. We see now, unfortunately, with the death of George Floyd, I hate that this video might be very dated in 2 or 3 years, but I'm sure the same issues are going to be coming up, unfortunately, over time. So, there are social issues that are going on right now. In now June 2020, there are social issues that are going on. And of course, companies are now focused on ethical behavior, focusing on our past, focusing on maybe our racist past, possibly. So it's all about, you know, ethical behavior, ethical leadership in a company. So keep this in mind. Today, and what is the whole point about why you have to be ethical today? And if you were in my BA 14 class, we spoke about that. Why do you have to be ethical today? Because everybody knows about it. Because of social media, everybody hears everything. And because of social media, if a company is not doing the right thing, it's going to be everywhere. It's going to be on Instagram, it's going to be on Facebook, it's going to be on Twitter. So it pays for a company to do the right thing. Okay? But remember, you want to do the right thing for the real reasons. You don't want it to be transparent. Okay? It's a broader view of leadership. Okay? Leadership is not autocratic anymore, where you're the boss and you say, you do this or else. It's not like that anymore. Distributive leadership, and if people had my class before, okay, this is BA 31, so many of you have had my class in person, you know the way I am with leadership in the class. I'm never the boss in the class, okay? I do distributive leadership. If people had me before, know that I don't decide when the test is, the class decides. They decide amongst each other, why do I do this? I do this because A, I can figure out who the leaders are and who the followers are. Not that it's a bad thing or a good thing, but also people can actually step up and say what their opinion is. And I don't have to decide when the test is because I'm not autocratic. I'd rather have distributive leadership. Okay, and that's the way it is in most environments today. The boss is always, it's not really on top anymore, but he's a little lower and he wants to be on the same level. We hear this all the time about how Sam Walton used to go to the stores and talk to, Sam Walton, the head of Walmart, used to go to the stores and talk to the employees. Just because the CEO of the company and he has $20 billion does not mean that he can't talk to what's going on, people on the bottom. So remember, it's not like this anymore, it's more like this. Okay? There's a demise of command and control. We're not going to control you and tell you what to do. It's more about, let's do this together, collaboration, and we're going to learn more about that. Okay? The influence of IT, information technology, a lot about what competition is doing and what's going on with IT is very important in the organization today. Okay? New workforce expectations. What do we mean by workforce expectations? We know today, with COVID, right? There's a lot of working from home. Workforce expectations. If you have a child, you can work from home with a child. Maybe have flexible hours. Workforce expectations. The days of 9 to 5 only are gone. Watch an old 50s film and you see people punching into work at 9 o'clock and leaving at 5 o'clock. I don't know anyone that does that today. Not even me. This is 8 o'clock. I started this at 8. It's now 8:30. I started this video at about 8 o'clock in the morning setting everything up. Okay, there's no 9 to 5 anymore. Okay, and there's a changing concept of careers. Used to be you work your way up. Okay, I'm going to go up the corporate ladder. It's not like that anymore. Some people leave. Some people have children and then leave and then come back. Other people have an idea of work-life balance. Maybe I don't want to be the boss. And we're going to be learning a lot about that from my own experiences as well. And there's a concern for sustainability, recycling, sustainability, doing the right thing in reference to the environment. These are all trends that are going on now in organizations and organizational behavior and in reference to human behavior at this moment. Okay? Scientific foundations is that they use scientific methods and models to figure out what works and what doesn't work. Everything that I'm going to talk to you about in OB has been studied. This is all scientific. This is not mumbo-jumbo, some kind of anecdotal evidence. This has been studied and researched for many years. And because of that, they can come to conclusions to say this is the way we want our work work to happen. Scientific thinking, data collection, control, and only explanation that can be rigorously verified. Like I said, you can't just say, oh, this guy likes to come in late, so we're going to change our hours from 11 to 7 because he likes to come in late. No, it's been studied scientifically to determine what the right thing is for the organization. Okay, everything's evidence-based, hard facts, we use hard facts, not just anecdotal, okay? And empirical evidence. What does the word empirical mean? Based on observation rather than theory. I have a theory about this. No. Let's study the theory that you have, test it, and then we can figure out whether this is the right thing for the work environment. Okay? Evidence-based thinking is through a contingency approach. What does the word contingency mean? Contingency approach in reference to organizational behavior. Contingency. One size does not fit all. That's the best way to think of what contingency means. One size does not fit all. You can't have the same standards or the same rules for everybody, because then there might not necessarily be a certain fit. Okay, so you want to have a contingency approach in reference to running your organization. Everybody has different requirements, everybody has different skills. And if you run the organization with the same rules for everyone and not take a contingency approach, it's not going to be as successful as if you focus on the organizational behavior aspect of contingency thinking. And here's contingency thinking, exactly what I just said. Okay, it seeks ways to meet the needs of different management situations, not one size fits all. Okay? Recognize responses to solutions may be crafted to best fit the circumstances and people that are involved. Like, once again, the great thing about this book is that we repeat a lot of the same stuff. So, remember, each person has to be managed differently. When I was working in Macy's selling furniture at one time, there's 20 people on the sales floor. Everybody comes from a different environment. Everybody was different. We had a fabulous manager who would really manage each one of us differently. Can you imagine? She had to have a different approach to managing each one of us differently to best fit the circumstances and for the betterment of the department and for Macy's itself. Of course, I'll always say Macy's is probably the worst place to work, but I had a great department and a great manager. And the great thing about the great department and great manager in a place like Macy's is that she is she's the wrong person for them, because Macy's just does everything wrong. Here's a little tidbit. Sell Macy's stock short, okay? They're not gonna last too much longer. Just because I work there and I see the way the environment is, there's no way that this company can be successful going forward. You can take my word for it or not, but my advice to you is, you watch a company like this and you can watch, because they don't take an OB approach to their organization. Herald Square has 5,000 people working there. Because they don't take an OB approach, this is why sales go down. This is why customer service is so low. This is why they're not doing things right. And we're gonna talk a little about my opinion about what's going on over there. But my manager was great. My department was great. We always made money in the department. It was always a successful department considering we were selling furniture. But that was because my manager took a contingency approach to each one of us, and that made us happy and, of course, brought morale up. Okay, one size does not fit all, exactly what I said. Okay, cross-cultural awareness. The awareness that we all come from different backgrounds, different countries, different backgrounds. You have to understand the culture of different backgrounds. When I was in Macy's, talk about diversity, everybody was so different, okay? I was a Jewish guy, we had Orthodox Jews, we had African Americans, we had a Pakistani guy, we had a Muslim guy who used to pray in the middle of the afternoon. We had Hispanics, we had one guy that all he cared about was making money. Everybody was so different. And of course, because of that, the diversity, we were successful. And we're gonna talk about more of that, okay? The management process, understand the management process. If you had BA 11 with me, we already spoke about this, management process. Planning, organizing, leading, and controlling. Know each one of those, okay? Here it is. Planning, choosing the goals, organizing, creating the structure to make that happen, right? Leading, inspiring people to do that work, controlling. What does control mean? Control is not this. If you had me before, you know what the word control is. Control, reevaluate, the control phase. The control phase of everything in marketing is reevaluate. The control phase here is reevaluate. Measuring performance and ensuring the results. If things aren't working, you reevaluate and you go back to planning. Choosing the goals, right? Once again, creating the structures, okay? Inspiring people, and then if it's working, keep it going. If it's not working, change and go back, okay? Remember, planning, organizing, leading, and controlling. Management process, okay? And this is all about it, okay? We don't even need that slide, okay? What's a stakeholder? Stakeholder, everyone that has a stake in the company. It comes from the word shareholder, right? Stakeholder, everyone, people, group that have affected, have an interest or stake in the organization's performance. If you had me before, you know my famous line about a stakeholder. Who's a stakeholder in Starbucks? The line was, the cup guy, the guy that makes the cups, okay? If business is good, it's gonna affect his business. He's gonna make more money. If business is bad, it's gonna go down. During COVID, when Starbucks was closed for 2 months, did it affect the cup guy? Of course it did, there were no cups. He was probably closed as well. But everyone that has a stake in the company, customers, the cup guy, landlords, in reference to Starbucks. I'm a stakeholder in Starbucks, I love Starbucks. Hey, wait, I even have my little Starbucks cup here. So, this is no advertising, I get nothing by saying this. Maybe I should get something for saying this, but anyway. So everybody has a stake or an interest in the organization's success, okay? Organizational culture, shared set of beliefs and values. Organizational culture, the way the organization runs, right? Organizational climate. So think about organizational culture and organizational climate. A shared perception of members regarding what the organization is in terms of practice. Let's talk about some organizational culture that most people understand. Google's organizational culture. What is it? There's free food. You can play games all day. You can bring your dog. You can come dressed any way you want, right? That's the organizational culture. When I worked for Polo Jeans, organizational culture was we wore jeans every day, right? We wore Polo Jeans. It was a jeans. It's a jeans company. That's part of the organizational culture. There are some cultures, maybe like a Goldman Sachs, maybe it was 30 years ago, where you had to wear a suit and tie. That was their organizational culture. That's just one part of organizational culture. It could be some places on Monday morning, what do? They talk about Game of Thrones from Sunday night, and they don't do any work until 11 o'clock. That could be part of organizational culture. Where I worked, because we were worried about sales over the weekend, because I worked a lot of it as an analyst in retail analysis, vendor analysis, and data analysis, I used to have to see numbers every Monday morning. So you couldn't sit by the water cooler and talk about Game of Thrones. You had to be at your desk getting the numbers and analyzing the numbers, and then we can make decisions based on, like we talked about, controlling, right? We already did the planning and organizing. Now we have control. We have to figure out, let's see what the numbers did. Let's fix anything that needs to be fixed. Okay, so that's organizational culture, organizational climate. So remember, this whole chapter one pretty much discusses everything that we are doing the whole semester. That's really the key, okay? Workforce diversity is all about individual differences based on gender, race, ethnicity, age, okay? Sexual orientation, workforce diversity, we bring everybody different, ambulances outside. Okay, individual differences in the workforce. Okay, multiculturalism, pluralism. Okay, multi, right? Multi, many, culturalism, pluralism. Different types of people, different types of cultures in the work environment. And of course, inclusion. We want to have diversity. And I'm gonna explain to you as time goes on why I believe diversity is a good thing. And like I said, I'm not saying it's a good thing only because, oh, we should all be together. I don't see diversity for that particular reason. Okay, well, we're gonna talk all about that. So this is just a basic overview of organizational behavior in chapter one. Inclusion, the idea of an organization respects and includes and encourages diversity, okay? What's a manager? Manager, someone is to directly support their employees. There are good managers and bad managers. There's an effective, but look at the difference. The manager does this, but an effective manager helps you achieve, not only gets you to do the job, helps you to achieve high performance in your job as well. So a manager, an effective manager, would also bring you up as well as bring the company up, okay? Achieve high level of both performance and satisfaction. Performance in the job and satisfaction for you. That's what an effective manager is. So, of course, would you rather be working with a manager or an effective manager? Of course, with a manager, right? With an effective manager, okay? Task performance, the quality of the work, you know. The great thing about organizational behavior, guys, the words are regular English words, which is a great thing. Task performance, the performance of the task. Quality and quantity of the work, okay, provided by the work unit, okay? Job satisfaction, how happy you are in your job, right? Satisfaction of your job indicates how people feel about their work environment. Like I said, BA31, regular English words explain everything, okay? Managerial skills and competencies. Maybe I'll take a little bit of a break now, okay? How much more do we have? Let me take a little bit of a break. Back in 2 minutes.